Meet Me on South Street, the story of Philadelphia's premier rock and roll stomping ground. The original, the legendary, JC Dobbs.
Where do all the hippies meet? South Street, South Street. Where the dancing is elite? South Street, South Street.
The original name of the song was Sampson Street. Between Cab and Dave Apple and Bernie Lowe, they finally came up with South Street.
JC Dobbs became the stomping ground for many local, national, and international artists.
I'd like to dedicate this to the owner of JC Dobbs, one only, Mr. Joe. Stand and take a bow. Joe! Joe from Dobbs, ladies and gentlemen. I ain't gonna play to stand up. I don't think he can hear you.
And George came back and we were talking, so I said, I know a place, and I brought him up to Dobbs. And
Mark came to me and said, I heard this band playing in a club called JC Dobbs, and they were doing songs, they were doing your style stuff, but they weren't as good. And I went up there, and every time we played at Dobbs, the fee was $200, started at $100. We got it up to $200. And every time we play, they'd go, do you want more money? Because it only took about, a month? We packed the place every night. Pack. Everybody bought beer.
The J.C. Dobbs family together would host the Turkey Bowl, Memorial Day picnics, Thanksgiving dinners upstairs at J.C. Dobbs, and benefit concerts for many local needy patrons and local hospitals.
You don't hear of that anywhere. I don't care what, you know, I mean, not a dime was asked for, nothing, you know. I mean, everybody gave the gal something, you know, a tip for doing all the work. But I mean, where would you find that at today? It was done without even a thought, not even a thought of what's in it for me. They just knew they were all patrons of Dobbs. Anybody that didn't have a place to go to, come over here, we'll feed you. It's just the most remarkable thing I've ever, one of the most remarkable things I have ever experienced. And of the South Street crew, that stands up maybe first or second in my mind as an event.
On a floor in a bank in New Mexico, and they're just part of a dream that I thought that you knew, but I'll never know why the air is so clean, the children get to grow up running strong. Oh, I gave myself to you, but my timing, it must have been wrong.
every city had its club, its famous club, and I wanted to be there. I wanted to make that. And I saw so much talent in Philadelphia, and I knew how what the past had had, you know, happened with the with Dick Clark, and I knew that there were just people out there dying to become famous. And we started them off on a Monday night, and they worked toward the weekends, and consequently, we did create famous people out of Dobbs. And Dobbs was more than just a club. It was a meeting place during the day for South Street. South Street was a very eclectic community. It was just incredible. We had a health food store, we had a used clothing store, we had a tobacconist.
You know, there's never going to be another CBGB's. That, you know, had its own history. You know, and Dobbs is as prolific for Philadelphia as CBGB's was for New York. You know, Dobbs never played second fiddle to that situation up there. Dobbs was our CB's in a way. It was our place that put the city on the map musically. So I'm all for somebody trying to recreate that environment, but you know, it'll be new, it'll be different, which is as it should be.
Love me like a woman would. You gotta know where to go and know what feels good.
All the bands that play JC Dobbs always have good luck in the end.